You know, there's two ways of doing things. There's the right way and the wrong way.
How come I gotta wear this tie?
Because it's stylish. And with style, honey, you can grab the world by its throat. Listen to me, baby. We're standing on the precipice of a whole new precipice. And as we dream,
so shall we become.
Looks like we're back in business.
So scheme your idea.
You got some kind of a problem, kid?
We were planning a monkey romp. A gag.
Where's a goddamn Cadillac?
Well, David said he was taking it in for a tune-up like you told him.
I didn't tell him to take it in for a goddamn tune-up.
Must be a mistake. We thought you were someone else.
I'm the guy that you flung into the cotton picking trunk.
Put your hands on your head. I don't like surprises. Don't fuck with me.
Did Tim put you up to this?
Shut up!
You take them off your fucking head again, I'm gonna kill you.
You guys are friends of Big John's, right?
I'm the fairy princess.
Please don't hurt me.
Well, drop this scared act, okay? I'm the one who should be begging for a break here. He was gonna shoot me.
God!
Would you take 2, 3, 4 shots? Not one of them even grazed me.
They're blanks.
Well, let me tell you something. These... or not.
That looks like the real McCoy.
I'm gonna have to figure this one out on my own. The shit coming out of your two mouths ain't making no goddamn sense at all.
I have no idea what's going on.
Oh, please.
It's David's idea. He's always pulling stuff on his old man to piss him off.
Did Florence bring you in on this job?
Eat shit.
You don't get to talk to me like that.
Your friend Tonto here don't want to play by the rules.
You got something to tell me now, Pally?
We were supposed to fake a hit with our friend Tin, but you were standing there instead. Florence set up the kidnapping to get the cops out of town.
You get one real live bullet in here, son. If any of these yokels tries to be a hero,
freeze!
You take him out.
Everybody on the floor right now! I'm getting cheated out of my cut of the money by a bunch of kids playing cops and robbers?
Where is Florence? And where the hell is your third man?
Florence is supposed to meet us back here.
You wanted to shoot him, didn't you?
Stop!
Now this makes twice that you crossed me.
We're wasting time. You put that gun down, you get in the car, you take them two little pricks, and you get out front.
Where's the money?
The money's in the car. They split it up. You go your way, and I'll go my way.
Think you're pretty clever, don't you? Well, I know something that you don't. Nobody's dead till I've shot him. Three kids playing dress up, taking on two pros.
That's some pretty funny shit. I guess we're having fun now, huh?
Paul's a friend of mine, and I had done a play with Paul back in New York about 8 years ago with Daryl Hannah that. It's kind of like a development thing. I'm lucky in that all the directors I've worked with have been very different. You know, some being very technical, some being very cerebral, some being, you know, Paul would fall into the cerebral category. He can't complete a sentence, but he has a deeper understanding of character and how a character is driven within the story, you know, so it was very advantageous for us to have him on that level. He knew this was a very different movie, and his input and his creative, you know, mind in relation to making it all come together as far as the story was very helpful to everyone.
I met with Paul before I agreed to do this, and I spoke with him for about 2.5 hours, and immediately I knew that I could trust him, that I believed in him, that he had very strong vision, and he had a wonderful way with actors. He really understands actors, and I knew that I would be in safe hands.
The way Paul works is very quiet. He speaks in a really soft voice, and he knows what he wants to see. He's very subtle with it. He likes subtlety in a performance. but he also lets us go wild, crazy. So I think it's a good balance.